is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to Auto Auction Rebuilds. If you're wondering why I got a ridiculous smile on my face today, it's because today I spent more money on one car than I had ever spent at any auto auction in the past. Guys, today I wrote a check for $6,710 to Copart for a $20,000 car. I got a 2008 Mercedes-Benz S63 AMG 518 horsepower under the hood, and I got it for $6,710 out the door. $6,000 winning bid. Nobody bid against me. It was at $5,600, $5,800. I threw a $6,000 bid on it and I won. In fact, why don't I show you that real quick before I show you the car?
Looks like my car is coming up on the block, guys. I'm winning it currently. The 08 S63 AMG for $6,000. I don't anticipate I'm going to be the high bidder for long. It's a pure sale. Are you serious? I won. Oh my God, I won.
Now, I've said many times that I was going to start the new year off with a bang, and I did. I'm still winning other cars too, guys. This isn't the only one. In fact, the next one that I may end up with is probably another $6,500 to $7,000. I wanted to make sure we started 2021 off with a bang. So, if all goes well, this video will come out on New Year's Day. So, Happy New Year, ladies and gentlemen. I want to thank all of you for being here, for joining me on this special occasion. It's not every day that Auto Auction Rebuilds picks up something this nice. In fact, it just never happens. Auto Auction Rebuilds never picks up anything this nice. All we do is hoopties. And I guess technically this could be considered a hooptie, although I don't know, guys. I don't know. I need to put a little air in the front tire. I did bring my air tank with me. I showed this car before. We'll go over the body a little bit better here. But first, let's step into my office. The only warning light on the dash, other than service being exceeded, is TPMS, and we do have a low tire, so, and I forgot to turn this off. This is actually still on. Oh, and there goes the car lowering itself back down. Oh man, heated seats. This thing is phenomenal. In fact, it is rather cold outside. I don't remember where the heated seats were. I don't know. Maybe they're over this car. Look, this car has so many buttons, guys. I don't even know where to start. Where I will start with those, turning the heater on, because it is cold out. I'm gonna go ahead and let the car warm up a little bit. We'll pop the hood. There's the heated seats right there. Let's go ahead and get those going in advance. We'll pop the hood and I'll roll this window down, because, well, I don't want to risk I don't want to risk getting locked out of the car. So obviously she's got a tad bit of damage. It doesn't appear to be anything serious to me. Now I'll have to take it to somebody and have them look at it and tell me what they think. I think all of this will buff off. I think all of this will also buff off. In fact, I think all of this will buff off too. You can't buff off a dent though, and we have a fairly significant dent right here in this flare on this fender. Now maybe a good PDR guy can tap that out and make it look decent, and maybe not. I don't know. The wheels, I'm sure 99% of you are gonna hate the wheels and you're gonna want to see stocks back on it. Maybe we'll see. I actually think the wheels look pretty good, but I am not a diehard Mercedes-Benz enthusiast either. There's a lot of you out there that take these cars very seriously, and you've already called out the wheels on this thing. So here she is, right? 518 horsepower. There it is, man. Handcrafted by I can't read that, honestly. I have no idea what that says. Let me see if I can get you guys in a little better here. Maybe you can read it for me, because I just can't, I can't make that out. Yeah, I don't know. I don't know. Hey, maybe we'll get lucky, and the guy that built it will be watching the video, and he'll be like, that was me! There she is, guys. In my opinion, a beautiful car. A beautiful car. Nothing too major other than it looks like we got a little crack on this bottom bumper here. A tiny crack. Other than that, the rest of the car looks really good. The tires have good tread, and I showed you before, but I'll show you again. Look at those massive brakes and rotors. Those things are insane, guys. Beautiful, beautiful interior. And yes, I am well aware that these engines are notorious for head bolt problems. And my buddy, who you guys may not remember, a lot of you are new here, but John, he actually works at Mercedes-Benz here in Oklahoma City. And this car has been there before. And he is looking up the history for me. And he's trying to find out if the head bolts or something on this car that have already been addressed. Because if so, that's great. If not, well, I'm not overly concerned about it. The car has lasted 175,000 miles as it is, and it seems to still be running strong. Now, we're going to find out. I think you guys may have noticed by now, we did not bring a trailer. Okay, we still got the spare. That's a big spare. Wow, that is a big spare. Yeah, we did not bring a trailer, guys. The truck is right there. So that means we have to drive it. Now, before we get very far, we're gonna have to put some air in that tire, and we're gonna have to hope that it holds air. Otherwise, I'm gonna have to put that spare on. But it looks like we've only got one tire that's down on air pressure. Actually, this one may be two. We should probably throw a little air in this one as well. Turn this on. I put just over 100 PSI in this tank just to make sure I had enough air to get this thing home. It's an hour drive. Just put a little bit of air in her and hope that it's good enough, right? I definitely don't want to overinflate it. Yeah. Let's focus more on this one, because this one for sure is flat. I'll get my air gauge out here in just a minute, and we can double check the air pressure. Hopefully this tire is okay. Please, 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 please air up. Come on, old girl. Yes, it looks like she's airing up. I would hate to know what these tires cost. These are Michelin. What are they, Pilot Sport? Yeah, these are Michelin Pilot Sport all seasons. I don't know what size they are, but these look like some these look like some expensive tires, guys. She come off the ground. There we go. There we go. That should be enough air to get us going, right? What do you think? Well, I don't know. Man, those tires just, they're so thin. And that back tire still looks like it's a little low too. What size are these? These are 3 pluses, and they are, I don't see the tire size. Oh, there they are. 255 35 ZR20s. Yeah, they're big tires. Especially on a car this old, you know? I'm gonna go ahead and add a little bit more air to these tires, and then I guess we can take her on her maiden voyage. All right, guys, it's time. Check tire pressure. Nothing like being greeted with a warning light as soon as you get in the car, right? Oh, it's nice and warm. Windshield washers, please. Thank you, because these windows are really dirty. There we go. That's better. That's better. We can see. Let me get buckled up, and then we'll hit the road running. Now, I kid you not, this damn thing has massage seats. Massage seats. Are you kidding me? Oh, no, dude. No. We cannot do massage seats This car is gonna put me to sleep, man. All right, guys, it's time. Yes, I am a little nervous. Whew. Here we go. Is the e-brake off and everything? Yeah. All right, car feels real heavy. Like real heavy. Here we go. Okay, first drive so far. I mean, you know, over the last 30 seconds, he's driving straight. Yeah, he's driving real straight. It feels like a tank, guys. It does not feel like a 500 horsepower car. It feels like a massive boat. Check tires, 33 and 25. So we know those work. Those work. Thank you. I got it. We'll check the tires later. Right now, I got to get on the road. So let me get off these back bumpy roads. Let's see what other error lights come on, because I'm just sure we're going to get a suspension issue or something. Something. This car can't be this good for what we paid for it. So we've made it back to the house. In fact, not only have we made it back to the house, we've made it all the way to the next day. It is now December the 30th, and I did spend a little time messing with this car to get some of the, I don't know what you would call them, the marks all down the side. I got them all off, guys, with a DA, a cutting pad, and a little bit of Meguiar's cutting compound. All of the marks that were here, running all down here, and then running all over here. Now, there is a mark here, a tiny one. I didn't buff that at all. I didn't try to cut that. But those marks went all the way over here. The worst of them were down here, though. You guys remember down here, there were lots of really bad black, like rubber marks. The marks that were all over this are gone as well. So I did that myself. And it all came off with relative ease. I have now put over 200 miles. In fact, I think we're close to 250 miles on this car today. And I'm here to tell you, there's only one thing on this car that doesn't work. One. Now, there's a reason for this. Any of you that know Mercedes already know the reason. You never ever fix every single problem with one of these cars. It's kind of just a rule. Everybody knows about it. You never fix every problem with one of these cars, because the moment nothing is broken, something catastrophic will happen. So you never ever ever fix every problem on this car. When I show you what it is that's wrong with it, it'll blow your mind. I love this, look at this, the touch to lock and the touch to unlock. I think that unlocked, or maybe it's this one that unlocks it. There we go. Yeah. The one thing that doesn't work on this car is absolutely ridiculous. It is that sunshade right there on the door. I can't get that sunshade to come down. That sunshade works, but that one right there is just stuck. The window will go down, but the sunshade will not move. We'll fire it up real quick, because nobody believes on social media, nobody believes that this car is fully sorted. And I say fully sorted, and I really believe that. Guys, you can see right on the dash, I have driven this car 227 miles. There are no warning lights on the dash. None. Nothing. Command center. Everything works. Everything works on the command center. Even the massage seats. There is nothing on here. In fact, let me turn this on real quick. Let's do fast and vigorous. Yeah. Oh. 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 Guys. Let me turn on the heated seats while I'm at it. There we go. We'll turn it on medium heat. This car... Can you tell I've never owned anything like this before? Oh. It's literally massaging my shoulders all the way to my butt. It is. This car gives a phenomenal massage. Oh, man. And it does it on the passenger seat, too. You could do the you could do the passenger side as well. If you scroll down, move over to the passenger seat. I'm not quite sure what this dynamic seat is. I haven't figured that out, so I just don't mess with it. But yes, the passenger seat has massaging as well. True dual zone climate control. The passenger has their own fan setting, guys. The passenger control their own heat, where it comes out of, and the fan speed at which it comes out as well. This car is so amazing. We have, I don't know what all of this is down here, but what I do know is that we have video up here. And if you click on video, this plays DVDs. DVDs. Now, I know that this is kind of old, so most people are watching Blu-rays or digital by now, but still, DVDs, this is super cool. Super cool. The headrests do work. The soft close doors work. Let me show you, because that'll be another thing. There is just nothing on this car that doesn't function. I'm going to gently close the door so that you can see the soft close function work. Bingo. Done. There we go. Yes, the soft close features work. The power trunk up and down works. Like, every light, every signal, the horn, every button, everything works. Look at these rear shades here. Okay, you can kind of see it there. That's the window. There's the shade. Okay, we'll pull it down. Unfortunately, like I said, that one just rolls the window down. It doesn't even attempt to roll the shade down. I'm not quite sure what that reason is. Something's obviously broken, but as you can see, the rest of the car works. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. This car is in excellent running driving condition, like new tires. You just can't fault it. So I'm going to leave it to you guys to comment down below if you think I got a good deal. According to everybody on Facebook and Instagram, not only did I get a good deal, but I stole this car. Like, I should be in jail right now. You should put me in prison for grand larceny, because I literally, so maybe grand theft auto, I feel that I stole this car. At the end of the day, that's all that matters, man. Even if I didn't get a good deal on it, as long as I feel like I got a good deal on it, it doesn't matter. The transmission shifts smoothly. It rides, oh man, it rides and handles like a Mercedes. I don't know what else to say. Remember, folks, I come from a trailer park in my youth. A lot of my childhood, I didn't even have a car. I used what we call Shoe Leather Express, and we rode the bus whenever we needed to get somewhere. So, I am not an expert on any Mercedes, all right? This being in this car today, truthfully, isn't even a dream come true. It's not. It's just so far beyond my imagination. And I know a lot of you are probably thinking it's an old Mercedes, whoop-de-doo. Well, you know, for you, congratulations. Life was good to you. Maybe you had a silver spoon in your mouth your whole life. I don't know. I didn't. I grew up with Spam in my mouth. All right. So sitting here today in an old 12-year-old S63 AMG, I'll be honest with you guys, I didn't even know what this car was back in the day. You know, I had no idea. The only reason I know anything about them today is because I've seen other YouTubers like Legit Streetcars, Sam Crack, Tavarish. I've seen these type of cars through their channels, and that's it. So I don't know anything about them, but what I can tell you is that the last S-Class I owned was also the first S-Class I owned. It was my, 2000 S600 V12, and that car, wow. There she is. V12. Let's have a look. All right, so here's the first look at the 2001 S600. Oh, looks like we've got some serious suspension issue going on over here. Did not see that. Hopefully it's some kind of an air ride that will pick itself back up. Again, it was just picked up in the air too, so it's possible. Is this an AMG? This has AMG wheels on it. It's got peanuts That's and rat's point. Nests all over it.
Yep.
Oh, we got a lot of lights. SRS, brake light. Does it go into gear? It does. Parking brake was on. Active body control, drive carefully. That car was my introduction to Mercedes-Benz, and it drove me crazy. I've got a series on that car a mile long. Man, we probably did 20 videos on that car because every time I turned around, the ABC suspension was failing. I replaced accumulators, I replaced struts, I replaced leaking lines. I replaced the air pump in the trunk that goes to the soft closed doors. That car, well, let's just say it didn't leave a fond impression on me of Mercedes-Benz. So when this one came up, I was kind of like, no, I don't need that headache. But the thing is, the car is great content. It truly is. And anytime you buy a car like this, you're taking a risk, man. So make sure that the money that you're putting at risk is money that you can afford. It's like gambling. It is. You know, only spend as much as you're willing to lose. And I feel that I got very, very lucky with this car because almost everything aside from the sunshade works and it drives phenomenally. And I love how the car greets you when you step in. And that the sound, it's just got this beautiful... The engine sounds so amazing on this car. Yes, service exceeded. Thank you very much. I don't even know what service B is. I do know that it's up to date on its oil change, though, so I am not concerned about that. It has had, according to Under the Hood, recent motor mounts, recent drive belt, recent radiator hose, recent coolant, spark plugs. What else? I don't remember. There are so many things under the hood of this car written down that it's had serviced on. And it's also been serviced a lot by Mercedes-Benz of Oklahoma City. And we're still waiting to hear back on the what kind of service this car has had from them. I'll tell you this, guys. The car is phenomenal. For $6,700, guys, I'm thinking of all the different regular, traditional American cars that I could have bought and how normal and honestly kind of boring they are. And being able to buy something like this from the auction that's in this good a condition for $6,700 just blows my mind. It absolutely blows my mind. This car is a joy to drive, but as with all of these big Mercedes, you have to be prepared because they're a devil, man. They're a devil. When they run and they drive like they're supposed to, they are so unique. They are in a league of their own. But when they break, prepare to go bankrupt, especially when you're like me and you don't have an infinite number of dollar bills at your disposal. Boy, that ding right there just kills it, man. It does. Hopefully, we've already been in contact with the PDR guy. We're going to see if there's something that can be done to at least make that look a little bit better. Of course, the AutoSpot LLC will probably get this car, polish it up, and make her look new again. Now, for those of you that are first-timers to the channel, you're brand new here, I'd like to say welcome, and, you know, keep in mind, I've got more cars than just the S-Class, although that's probably the only one you would be interested in. I've got a 2020 Jeep, I've got a 2019 Ram 2500, I've got a SN95 that I picked up for $410 or $450 from IA Auctions right here. Great running driving, 5-speed, V8, obviously GT. We've got the $175 1990 Ford Tempo, the free swamp Corvette that sat in a swamp in Florida for something like 14 years that we got running and driving. This car right here doesn't count. It belongs to a gentleman that's in Mexico. I'm just holding it for him until the pandemic lets him come get it. Ooh. I call this Bonacart. Truthfully, it's just junk. It's a completely junk car that I just cut a bunch of the parts off of for fun. We have, I almost forgot I even had this car. This is, what, an 89 or a 90 Mercury Cougar LS that we used some head gasket repair on. We found this at the auction for next to nothing as well. $250, I think. Runs and drives just fine now. Needs a little exhaust work. Then this one should be ready to go up for sale. Then, of course, we have Vet Cart, sort of. It really is just a parts car for Swamp Vet. We took everything that we needed off of it. It still runs and drives, although I wouldn't recommend it in its current condition. We won this car for $2,000, and it was actually in really nice shape. Unfortunately, as soon as I got it home and I took it out and romped on it for the first time, we lost third gear in the transmission. And about that point, I got really upset with it, and I tore it apart and used it for parts for a swamp car that probably should have never been put back on the road again. Last but not least, well, it's not exactly last, but we have the Fox Body Mustang GT that we picked up from Copart for $3,000. Came out to about $3,600 out the door, and it was supposed to have like an $8,000 engine. It doesn't have an $8,000 engine. I'm just here to tell you, stock injectors, stock distributor, it's got blow by worse than a steam engine, man. I mean, it's bad. It's real bad. But Weird Beard has agreed to come down, and we're going to jerk this motor out, and then we're going to get into it. We're going to find out what's wrong with it. We're going to try to fix it and put this one back on the road, because truthfully, this is a pretty decent car. It just needs a few minor repairs and she should be good to go. It's a little dirty, but even the interior isn't bad on this. It just needs a good cleaning. And then we have the 1959 Dodge Coronet that Weird Beard is doing pretty much a body restoration. I took a few minutes last night and I climbed underneath the old girl to see if there were any major leaks that I should be worried about. And guys, as with everything else on this car, it blew me away. Not a drop, not a drip. There is nothing leaking underneath, nothing, nothing at all. It's even got almost brand new tires. Like, there is really not much of anything on this car that needs to be done. But I want to know what you guys think about me taking it to the Mercedes dealership in Oklahoma City and paying them a fairly substantial sum of money to do what I like to call a PPI, not a pre-purchase inspection, a post-purchase inspection. And we will get them to find anything and everything possible wrong with this car. And then we can do a video about how much it would take to make this car 100% as good mechanically and electronically as it was the day it came out from the factory. I know a lot of you are new subscribers and you probably don't know who Weird Beard is. And for those of you that don't know him, you need to go check him out. I have a link in the description down below. Click on it. Go check out Weird Beard and his restoration of the 59 Dodge Coronet. He's also got his own stuff going on, man. Like, he's got so many projects on his table right now. I don't know how he does it, but he's got a lot of work going on. His kids are YouTubers. Very cool guy. Very cool family. They're good people, man. So go check them out. Like I said, link in the description down below. That is going to be it, guys. But before we go, remember, if you want to see a pre-purchase inspection from Mercedes-Benz of Oklahoma City, I'll pay for it, man. I will absolutely go down there and I'll hand them my money. But you guys, I got to let me know by hitting that thumbs up button and dropping your comments down below. Let me know if you want to see this car get a PPI. If you think I got a good deal, let me know. If you think I got a bad deal, let me know. Either way, we're out of here, guys. Hope you enjoyed the content. Stay safe out there, and I will catch you all very soon in the next one.